Hello, hi friends, my name is Nilesh. In this video, we are going to see how to use Loki as a log aggregator. Sometime back, one of the viewers of my YouTube video, he asked me to show how to set up Loki, as I've shown in other videos, how to set up things like Prometheus, how to set up RabbitMQ on a Kubernetes cluster or Azure Kubernetes Service managed cluster. So let's get started and see how do we get Loki installed on Kubernetes. If you don't know what is Loki, Loki is an open source project. It's by Grafana Labs. And if we head over to the Loki main page or the web page, we see that it is open source, a set of projects or components that can be composed into a fully featured logging stack. Earlier, I had done video in terms of how to set up or how to build applications which are using the 15-factor applications. And one of the factor in distributed applications or distributed microservices is to have the logs which are aggregated. We treat logs as a stream of events and we send them to a centralized place instead of having the logs stored locally onto different machines. That way, when we use cloud native application development and these practices, even if our application moves from one hosting environment to another, or if we use things like auto scaling, which can distribute pods or workloads on different nodes, we still have the logs which are sent to a central location and we can easily visualize those logs and extract information out of those logs. With that in mind, let's get started with Grafana Loki. If you want to understand how does Loki work, I will put a link to this page in the description of this video and you can get to know how Loki works internally. It uses an agent to push the logs to the Loki server and from there we can use visualization tools to visualize the logs which are written by the application. So I have this cloud native ninja application which writes logs entries as and when there is the processing happening. So I have a RabbitMQ producer and consumer. And if I look at this Go code, which I'm going to use or which I've already deployed to my Kubernetes cluster, the consumer writes this log every time it receives a message or it tries to process a message saying subscriber has received the data. It writes the JSON output and then it also unbundles that JSON data and writes things like what is the ID of the tech talk, what is the name, what is the category and the level. So this is the information we are expecting in our log entries to be seen. And I've already deployed this application. So I'm going to get started and see how do we go about deploying Loki onto the Kubernetes cluster. I'm going to use Helm, which is my preferred package manager for Kubernetes. And if I use this Helm list command, you can see that currently I have Prometheus and RabbitMQ as two Helm charts, which are available locally on my machine here. I'm going to add a repo. And in this, I'm going to specify Grafana Helm chart as the chart that I'm going to add locally. This is the chart which consists of or which includes the Loki Helm chart. Since I already have this Grafana, it is showing that the Grafana chart already exists. So in that case, I can go and run the Helm upgrade command and we can specify different parameters. So I'm going to use the install flag along with the upgrade. We can also do just Helm install, but I prefer to use Helm upgrade as an option and specify install as the flag. Loki is the name of our release. And then we specify Grafana slash Loki stack. Now, one of the prerequisite for this is that the Prometheus stack or the Kube Prometheus stack chart is also installed onto the Kubernetes cluster. Earlier on this channel, I've done a video which shows how to install Prometheus and the whole Kube Prometheus stack. So if you don't know how to do that, I suggest you have a look at that video and do that as a prerequisite for this particular installation of Loki. Because we are going to use Grafana, which is part of the Kube Prometheus stack as the visualizer, we set Loki is default as false as part of this installation. This is required because Grafana uses different data sources and by default in the Kube Prometheus stack, it sets Prometheus as the default data source. If we don't do this, then it overrides the default data source with Loki, and I do not want to do that. I still want to keep Prometheus as my default data source. That is why I set this Loki.isDefault equal to false. And when I run this, the Helm chart identifies that there is no release named as Loki in our Kubernetes cluster, and it installs it. Once this is installed, we already have the application which is running. We can generate the workload, and we can see the logs which are written to the aggregated location using the Loki visualizer, or using Grafana as the visualizer and Loki as the data source. Let's wait for a couple of seconds or until this installation is completed. And after that, we will generate the workload. Now, to generate the workload, if you have looked at this channel earlier, I again use this application called Cloud Native Ninja. And in that, we have one location, or we can use Postman to generate the request. So I already have the Tech Talks producer, which is producing the number of messages, and it is exposed on port 8080. I've done the port mapping here and exposed that as a service. And then I can use this generate method to generate a certain number of messages. So let's say I want to generate 10,000 messages. I can change this number from 5,000 to 10,000, and I can send that request. And then we would be able to see those messages being populated. So let's do this while the Loki is getting installed. And the installation has been successful. So we can see in the output here that the Loki stack has been deployed to our cluster. Loki is now added as a data source in Grafana, and we can go and have a look at that. Now, to confirm that the messages are getting populated, we can head over to the RabbitMQ user management UI, or RabbitMQ management UI. And we can see here that the total number of messages is so far 1,500 plus messages have been published to this queue, which is the Tech Talks consumer queue. And we do not have any consumers running. In a short while, we should see the auto scaling kicking in for this particular application, and the consumers are going to consume the messages. Once we have the consumer, we can then head over to the Loki Explorer. And while I was speaking, we can see one consumer has come up, and it will scale up to a certain limit based on our configuration. So now if I go to the Grafana dashboard, under the Explore, I can click on the Explore option here. And this is where we can see the different data sources which are configured in Grafana. We have Loki, we have Prometheus, which is the default. That is the Grafana itself. So I'll select Loki, and Loki uses this concept of different labels or filters. We can filter the logs based on different parameters. So I have a container which is named, and I can use that as my filter. I will be using this RabbitMQ consumer, where the container name is named as RabbitMQ consumer, and we can filter based on different time frames. Let's go and filter last 15 minutes. If I run this query here, I can also do a live query, which will keep showing me the results as and when they come, or logs as and when they come. But let's do a one-time query for now. So here we can see those logs written. This is what I was showing earlier in the Visual Studio code, that we have these log entries which talks about what is the category ID, what is the name, what is the JSON data which is coming, and the initial message which says that the subscriber has received the message. So this verifies that the log aggregation is working fine. And although we have at this point in time 30 different consumers running, we would be able to see the logs from all those 30 different consumers. We do not have to go to individual pod and look at the logs of those. Loki is able to pull that information from all those consumers and centralize it into this one location. So with that, what we have been able to do is to easily set up Loki on the Kubernetes cluster using Helm chart. And it was a simple two-step process. We added the, if you want to set up the same thing, you can refer to this particular markdown file. So the first thing we did was to add the Helm chart for Grafana, which contains the Loki Helm chart, and then we ran the Helm upgrade command with this Loki is default parameter set to false. With that two simple steps, we are able to set up the Loki on our Kubernetes cluster, and we are able to see the logs which are aggregated in one location. I hope you found this useful. If you find the video useful, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching this. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.